communications, whether it's in a hazmat environment or a structural collapse environment or a confined space environment, is paramount. Basements, concrete structures, steel, sometimes the radio system won't penetrate that environment.
We had a recognized gap in being able to provide a real-time video feed from a hot zone to a cold zone. Our ability to talk to each other reliably has the potential to really change the outcome of any operation.
The Vorbeck HD4 vest provides live, full motion, high definition video, audio, and streaming data from difficult communication environments back to incident command and to every member of the team. The Vorbeck vest has the antennas, all the ancillary electronics. We have a Rajant ES1 radio embedded behind the main chest plate of the vest. That radio is the main communications link and also all of the processing for the mesh network from vest to vest and with the nodes as well. Using the Rajant TROIP system, tactical radio over internet, you can establish audio connections between members in a mesh network without any external server or routers or anything like that. So all they need to carry in is a vest. We also have portable nodes that allow them to communicate, and that establishes the data flow, but also the audio flow.
Our ability to take a camera and place it in an intermediate space that we've already assessed and determined to be reasonably safe from a hazardous materials perspective, that does two things. It gives us a bigger view of the overall situation, as well as relaying the information, video, and audio feedback to the command post. Bringing all this technology together, the reliability, the ease of setup, what we're able to do is communicate what we can see and really take advantage of subject matter experts.
The combination of the voice, the video, etc., gives the connectivity between the people in the hot zone and incident command so much more data. We also took the system to New York City, and we're able to get communications from the 80th floor and up in World Trade Center 3 out to street level using the system. And so it's great for everything from underground all the way up to skyscrapers and high rises.
If we have good communications, we can cut down on that time it takes us to effect a rescue or mitigate the hazmat incident.